Welcome. My name is Kevin Fallis. I'm a Principal Analytics Specialist Solutions Architect, and I work with the Amazon OpenSearch service to help customers such as yourself understand the feature sets. Today, we're going to understand security in the Amazon OpenSearch service. Now, the Amazon OpenSearch service is a fully managed service that makes it easy to deploy and operate and scale OpenSearch clusters and legacy Elasticsearch clusters on the AWS cloud. Now, what is OpenSearch? OpenSearch is a community-driven open source search and analytics suite, which is derived from Apache 2.0 license, Elasticsearch 7.10.2, and Kibana 7.10.2. It consists of a search engine, which is called OpenSearch, and a visualization and user interface, which is called OpenSearch Dashboards, as well as a series of functionality-adding tools and plugins that make life easier, such as the security plugin that I'm going to discuss here in the slides following on. So why Amazon OpenSearch Service Security? Well, first of all, you can confidently host PCI DSS, HIPAA, FedRAMP, and other sensitive workloads on the Amazon OpenSearch Service. You can protect sensitive data using fine-grained access control and data masking mechanisms. You can integrate with third-party identity providers for direct SAML integration for a single sign-on experience. You can secure your data at rest and in transit. You can audit activities on both the control plane and the data plane. And finally, you can control programmatic access from AWS services and processes using AWS identity and access management. So if we look at the transit layer for encryption, effectively you have your leader nodes and your data nodes. Between the leader nodes and data nodes, we use TLS 1.2 to secure that data in flight. Next, you want to go ahead and enable node-to-node encryption to enforce HTTPS at the edge for a secure all-around transit layer encryption setup. Additionally, you can configure DNS and bring your own certs to the Amazon OpenSearch service from a DNS perspective should you choose to use a portion of your DNS naming standards for the Amazon OpenSearch service so you can have a custom-friendly domain name. So to do this, you basically create or install a certificate on the AWS Certificate Manager. And once you've done that, you reference that certificate and provide the friendly DNS name that you want associated with your Amazon OpenSearch service cluster. Then your clients that are accessing either dashboards or programmatically accessing your data will be able to securely reference that data over the wire in flight through the transit layer using the mechanisms that we've spoke about. Now, from a REST layer perspective, we do support encryption at rest. And this is enabled from versions 5.1 onwards. So it uses the AWS Key Management Service, KMS, to store and manage those keys. It's AES 256 encrypted, and you can either create those keys and bring them to the service, or AWS, the Amazon OpenSearch service, can provide a key for you if you don't want to create it. Now, what it covers is the indices. It encrypts the OpenSearch or the Elasticsearch logs. It will encrypt the swap files, the automated snapshots, and all of the data in the application directory on the disk that supports the data nodes that hold your data. Now, from an authentication perspective, there are multiple provider integrations, and there's three of them. The first one's basic auth, which most of us should know. Basically, it's a username and a password in a configured local database that gives you some level of security above and beyond no authentication. And the way it works is you put a user in that basic auth database, and then you can sign on to the Amazon OpenSearch service or programmatically use those credentials to interact with the data that's on the service. Next, you have IAM authentication. Now, this is typically leveraged with Cognito, but you can also use it for SIGBI 4 request signing your requests from your programmatic processes that can then talk to the Amazon OpenSearch service. And the way this works is that AWS IAM identity is defined. It uses SDS to generate credentials and tokens, and then Cognito will leverage that to then forward it to the Amazon OpenSearch service where SIGBI 4 request signing is done, and then that enables you to have a secure solution using IAM authentication. Finally, there's SAML authentication, and this is that third integration I've talked about. So it does use third-party identity providers such as Okta, Ping, Active Directory, and other things that support SAML 2.0 compliance. Now, the authentication is done at the provider, and the authorization in this case will then be done at the Amazon OpenSearch service, and this is highly secure. So the way it works is that you configure your users into provider, you establish a certificate with the Amazon OpenSearch service, and then once that's been set up, then the Amazon OpenSearch service will work with your provider to then provide that as an authentication mechanism. Now, from an authorization perspective, we leverage the security plugin that I talked about earlier. Now, this supports multi-tenancy, cluster-level security, index-level security, document-level security, field-level security, and it even supports field masking. And the way this works basically is that you either have an IAM role, a basic auth user, or some SAML attributes that you provide for role mappings. These role mappings are then associated with a role that gives you the granular access of your choice. And again, these things could be an index or field level or document level or even the masking that we talked about. And so then when you access that data, either through your client or through OpenSearch dashboards or Kibana, you will see only the data that you've authorized those users to leverage for their work. So from an auditing perspective, we have control plane auditing that's covered by AWS CloudTrail. This will cover any command that's done from the control plane, such as resizing your cluster, deleting your cluster, and whatnot. Now, if you want deeper knowledge of what requests have came in, you can use the auditing on the data plane. So the security plugin does provide a mechanisms for auditing every request should you choose to enable that. And you can see many details such as rest method, the user that accessed it, the query that was performed, any headers, any endpoints that they access, and this all gets logged for you to assert that you have the proper security for your particular users. Now, in summary, the Amazon OpenSearch service supports the following: encryption at rest, IAM integration, fine-grained access control, encryption in transit, auditing at both the control plane and the data plane, and also IDP integration with your favorite provider for single sign-on activities. So I really want to thank you for your time today. I know that your time is valuable, and we really appreciate your interest in the Amazon OpenSearch service. Hopefully today, this information has enabled you with the details that you need to explore further. Thank you.